So let us move forward with the next part, that is general considerations in machine design. So here I would like to mention that this is the most important theory part, wherein in some of the papers it was asked for 10 marks and normally it comes for 5 marks. So this question generally you will find in most of the papers: explain or enlist general considerations in machine design. What are the general considerations in machine design? So you can expect any of the questions, but the answer will be same, wherein you have to give general considerations in machine design. So now again, your work will be more. I will showcase some pics and you have to guess what can be that consideration in the machine design. So my first pick to you all is this one. What can you say about this?
Forces acting on the object.
Okay, forces acting on the object. Good. Try to be more specific. You are on the line, but not
equal amount of forces acting on body.
Equal and opposite forces acting on the body. No.
Sir, stress acting on different machine components.
Stress acting on different materials.
Sir, vertical forces acting.
Vertical forces acting. Okay, good. That is your observation. Okay, so all of you gave the nearest answer and I will club all that and I will say that the first consideration in machine design is what is the type of load acting on the component and what is the stress developed by that. So in this case which is shown to you, I can say that the load acting on this particular design component will always be compressive. Okay. So taking into the consideration compressive strength of material, that material should be, or that part should be designed, because when it is applied on the machine, it will be always experiencing a compressive load. So first step is to see what type of load will be acting on that particular element, or what type of stress will be coming on that particular element. So I think you also have to note down in your notebooks, the first point in general consideration in machine design is different type of load and stresses caused by the load. This is the first point. Okay, let me portray second figure. So this is the second one. What can you understand by this?
Sir, reciprocative motion, sir.
Very good. Reciprocating motion. Something more, add into it. Reciprocating motion is the correct one. What is, in generalized term, what you can say?
Sir, to and fro movement, sir.
To and fro movement. Okay, no, someone said now motion of the something. What is that motion of the?
Part.
Very good. The next consideration in machine design is motion of the parts, or in technical terms, I can say what is the kinematics of the machine? What type of motion that particular component will be going through? So this is my second consideration. So again, I repeat, first consideration was type of load and stresses caused by the load. The second point is motion of the parts or kinematics of machine, you can say in technical terms. Okay, so with this, let us proceed further with the third consideration, which is this one. What can you understand by this?
So the material of the...
Very good. The perfect answer. What kind of material will be used for that particular component? So again, going back, first step, type of load and stresses. Second step, motion of the parts or kinematics of machine. Third step, selection of material. Let us go to the fourth part, which is this one.
Sir, according to tool use. Selection of tools.
Okay, selection of tool. Something more, someone said.
Sir, maintenance.
Maintenance, okay.
Sir, arrangement of component.
Arrangement of components, no. Okay, I will say it. It is what should be the shape and the size of the part. What is the required shape and size of the part? Okay, for example, let us say we are designing the mobile. I want almost the shape to be rectangular. Can I design mobile circular? Yes. Can we design mobile as circular section?
No, sir.
Normally it is a rectangular component. So what should be its size? Agar suppose maine aapko de diya, the height of the phone or the rectangular phone which you are using is 1 feet. Will you use it?
No, sir.
No. No,
so sir. While designing the component, you also have to keep in mind where it will be used, what should be its size, and what should be its form, or what should be its shape. So again, I repeat the four things. The first one is type of load. Second one is motion of parts. Third is selection of material. Fourth one is form and size of the parts. Next part, this one. This is very easy to predict.
Lubrication.
Very good.
According to lubrication.
Yes, very good. What type of lubrication will be required in that machine part? For example, it is a mechanical part, so it will be requiring oiling. Which type of oil? The oil should not catch fire because of heat. So that you have to take into consideration. What amount of heat will be generated at that particular part, and then what is the suitable oil or coolant required for that particular part or machine part. Next part or next consideration is this one. What is this? The stress on this particular part. What I want to say by this particular part?
Handle.
Handle. ठीक है और कुछ दिख रहा है मुझे वहाँ पर?
Sir, automation of window.
Very good. Automation of window, or in other terms, I can say convenient and economical feature should be there. Now, just imagine there is a regular window, traditional window, wherein you have to rotate that knob and then it will go up and down. The mirror go up and down. So you have to do the rotation of that lever. Instead of this, if I get handy press button, then in place of just pressing the button, window can go up and down. So what you will prefer? The regular one, traditional one, or the press of button?
Press button.
It's simple. Press. It should be press of button. Why? Because it is very convenient to use. So your design part should be convenient and economic to use. So that is next design consideration. The answer is in the
safety
picture itself. Yes. It should be safe for working environment. Okay. It should be safe for operation. The next consideration is this one. What is this?
Production of process.
Production process, or in other terms, what you can say. Where do you find these machines?
Workshop.
Yes,
very good. So what are the workshop facilities available at your end? For example, you have designed a part. Just for example, you have designed a part in which you are told that I want a tolerance of 0.0001 mm. Okay, you have designed a part and you have written in the design drawing that the tolerance on this part should be 0.0001. So what the manufacturing team will do? Manufacturing team will say, I don't have that kind of machine only with me. How can I manufacture it? So that design goes wrong. So you have to also consider what are the different manufacturing facilities available or workshop facilities available at your end. Because yes, we can achieve that 0.001 accuracy, but for that, what we need to do? We need to give to outside vendor and he will be charging it more. So unnecessarily the cost will go on increasing. So you don't have to increase the cost if it is not required. Okay, next image is this one. What is this?
Production line.
Production.
Production line, yes, production. Something more added to production.
It's mass production.
Yes, very good. That's the term which I wanted. It's the mass production. So you have to also consider whether what you are designing will be a batch production, it will be a single production, or it will be a mass production. So that also you need to design and take into account that aspects also while designing the machine. Again, a simple term, that is cost. So cost should be on the higher side, right? Right or wrong?
Cost
should be on the higher side.
Low.
Suitable.
Low.
Yes. The cost should be on the lower side. As far as possible, cut down the cost. Use standards wherever available. Don't go for the special purpose machining or special parts. So if you go in that part, you will be reducing the cost automatically. Next part is this one. What is this?
Assembling.
Very good, very good, very good. That was the expected answer. It should be easy to assemble. Ab dekho, ek part humne design kiya, dusra part humne design kar liya. For example, the internal diameter of the bearing I have kept 20.2, for example. Internal diameter of the bearing is 20.2. And now I am designing the shaft with external diameter 20.3. Will it work?
No.
It will not work. Because I have not taken into account that this part will be assembling with this part. Agar yehi main nahi kar paunga, toh mera pura design fail ho jayega. So this are the consideration which we have to take into account while designing a machine, or we can say these are the general considerations in machine design. So quickly, some one of you revise all these points on the slide. What are the different machine design considerations? Quickly.
Sir, types of load and stress caused by them.
First is types of load. Second is
Motion of part.
Very good. Motion of parts. Third,
selection of material.
Selection of material. Very good. Fourth,
form and size of.
Form and size. Good. Fifth,
lubrication.
Lubrication. Sixth,
convenient and economical.
Convenient and economical features. Very good. Seven,
safety. Eight, workshop facilities
available. Nine,
type of production,
whether it is mass production, job production or batch production. Nine,
cost of production,
not cost of production only, cost of the machine, that includes everything. The total cost of the machine should not be more. Okay, and the last one,
assembly.
It should be fit or very easy to assemble. So this is the question wherein it contains 10 points. So when it comes for 10 marks, you have to elaborate all the points for 10 marks for, let us say, two-sided answer. And when it comes for 5 marks, you have to write all these points but explain only in brief. So you can expect this question in the main and semester exam. What are the general considerations in machine design? So let me proceed further with the next topic, or simple topic, again a very important question, which is, what is the general procedure in machine design? Earlier what we saw what are the general considerations, what you have to consider while designing a component. Now next step, again for 10 marks it comes in exam, or 5 marks, what is the general procedure in designing a machine or in machine design? So again the question in your code, what do you think can be the answer for this general procedure for machine design?
Sir, product ki need kya hai?
Product ki need kya hai? Very good. That's the most important point. What is the need of that product? Whether it is really needed. Agar need hi nahi hai to design kyun karna hai? That's a very good point. First step will be the need. What is the other steps? What can be the procedure? What is the general procedure in machine design? So someone said that the first step or the step will be the need. So yes, that's the right answer. The first step in any procedure of machine design is the need or the aim. Why we need that particular design? Okay, so this is the first step. Second step will be, what will be the mechanisms involved in it? Okay, so let us say it is a drilling machine. So what mechanism we require? It should rotate, the spindle should rotate, it should go up and down. What will be the mechanisms involved in it? For example, drilling machine, I said, if it is a milling machine, so it should perform that particular operation. If it is a shaping machine, it should have a reciprocatory motion or reciprocatory mechanism. So what mechanisms will be incorporated in that machine? That will be your second step. Third step will be the analysis of forces. What are the different types of forces acting on each element? This we have seen earlier also, whether that component will be based on compressive force, whether it will be tensile force, whether it will be shear force, whether it will be bending force. This analysis you have to do at the initial part. Then after finding out forces, next step will be material selection. You can see that it is exactly in line with the things which we have seen previously. First step, need or aim. Second step, mechanism. Third step, forces. Fourth step, material selection. Then fifth step will be design. Design based on empirical relation you can do. You can go by industrial design. You can go by rational design. Normally what we will follow will be the rational design based on the formulas. So from that we will find out the size of the element. Then sixth will be modification. Now let us say you have designed something and then you came to know that this part, for example, what I took earlier, that one part or the coupling internal diameter is 20.2 and I have designed the shaft as 20.3. So that will not work in assembly. So what I will do, I will modify my design. Either I will increase the diameter, internal diameter of the coupling, or I will decrease the diameter of the shaft to make them assemble. So these are the modifications which you need to do after your initial phase of design. Then after all modifications have been done, you have to go for detailed drawing of the same. Now detailed drawing, what it includes? It includes what tolerance you have to give, what type of surface finish you want, what kind of assembly you want there, press fit, transition fit, etc. That is known as the detailed drawing. And after all this step, the last step will be the production, wherein everything will be go for producing. So these are the steps of, you can say, general procedure in any machine design. So again, I repeat, first step will be need or aim. Second will be what are the different mechanisms to be used. Third will be what kind of forces are acting on that particular element. Fourth will be what would be the material for that particular element. Fifth will be the size of that element. Sixth, modification if required. Seventh is the detailed drawing given to the production house. And the last one will be the production. And that completes the general machine design procedure. Any doubts to anyone?
No, sir.
So I will stop the lecture here. So what we have studied today, we have seen initially what we have seen. Okay, someone gives the quick revision of the today's lecture. What we have started.
What is machine?
Yes, we started with what is the machine, then
design.
Then design. Okay, good. Then
the combination of machine and design.
Then what is machine design? Okay, very good. Then we saw
consideration.
Yes. General machine design. In machine design. And finally, now we saw what is the general procedure to be adopted in machine design. So normally these two questions, again I repeat, normally these two questions, general considerations in machine design and general procedure in machine design, normally comes for 10 marks. Not 10, 5, at least 5, not less than 5. So these two are the important questions and mostly it will be also part of your assignment, but I will not disclose it now. I will let you know later what are the questions given for the assignment. Okay, so hope you have enjoyed this part and you have understood what I was trying to convey. So anyone has any doubt, they can ask, or if they have marked the attendance, they can leave the meeting. Thank you.